other people. It's Rob Lee. In my time on YouTube, almost 4 years, in December it'll be 4 years, I've did a lot of videos about the church. And some folks have said that I've been too hard on the church. And quite frankly, I don't think I've been hard enough. So I want to explain to you, and I just want to show you 17 facts that may change your mind about a lot of the things that people, when they try to defend the church, how you can give this to them, and you will see that they have no answer, none, no answer for it at all. To be in church today is to be a mental and spiritual and physical slave. They take your money and they spiritually reduce you to nothing. And that's what church truly is. You end up broke, you end up spiritually stunted, confused, and lost, and you think you are a part of something. The modern day church is there for one reason. The modern day church serves Mystery Babylon. The modern day church serves the state of Israel. The modern day church serves the six-pointed star, period. That's it. And it is one of the greatest tools that the evil of this world has. Period. Now let me show you 17 facts about the church, and I just want you to think. And number 17 is so mind-blowing. And listen, folks, you can go check this out for yourself. It's easy to find out. Number 17 is so mind-blowing. It's really hard to even wrap your head around it. 17 facts about the corrupt and vile church of today. According to this list, excerpted from a list of requirements for 501c3 churches, and C is the third letter in the alphabet, and 3C, there's your 33 churches, put out by the Department of Treasury Internal Revenue Service Publication 18269-94, category number 21096G. Churches must, number one, become a business. So every church that you see today, they are a business. They are controlled by the corporation. They are controlled by the Babylonian bankers. There's number one. Boom, done, over with. Number two, have a recognized creed and IRS-approved form of worship. Now, when you think IRS, think Babylon and the state of Israel, because that's what it is. Number three, have an IRS-approved code of doctrine. Think about it, brethren. Number four, have ordained ministers educated in state-accredited colleges. So the people, the monsters who teach or pretend to teach in these churches come from Babylonian schools. This is the truth. Be neutral on political issues. It means that you must be dumb as a fence post and you must be spineless and weak. Your allegiance must be to the devil, it must be to Babylon, and it must be to the state of Israel. No matter what crimes are committed, you must be loyal to evil. Number six, have tax-exempt status issued by the IRS. Seven, pastor must answer to the IRS as to daily activities of the church. Number eight, the IRS, and remember, we know what the IRS is. Think Federal Reserve. The IRS must be privy to all financial transactions of the church. Number nine, pastors must supply names of all donors, make book records available. Number 10, may only use IRS approved fundraising methods. Number 11, pastor will be called to account over any stand taken against the tax system, because the federal income tax, the federal tax laws are actually unconstitutional. They're a lie. They're a lie created by Babylon. They don't want you to stand up to it. They don't want you to tell any truth. Number 12, church must advocate and support racial integration. Now, it's a man or a woman's choice to be around any other man, woman, black, white, tan, yellow, red, yellow, brown. It does not matter. That's your individual choice. Now, they are taking that away from you and telling you that you must. 13, may not engage in activities opposing pornography. Now, if you need to watch complete strangers fornicate, what's wrong with you, boy? I mean, really, what's wrong with you, man? Where is your mind? Where is your spirit? Now they're telling the church, don't you dare say anything against it, because if you do, you will find out that the ones who are behind the pornography are the same monsters that prop up the old six-pointed flag. Oh, you better believe it. 14, may not support legislation saying children belong to parents rather than the state. Oh my goodness. So the church cannot support any legislation saying that our children belong to us rather than the Babylonian state. Because to take over any country, to take over a people, you got to start with the little ones. 15, may not form a political action committee nor support legislation opposing lotteries and gambling activity. 16. May not oppose the public school system, which is where all the hate, corruption, and lies start when you start with the little ones. From the time they go to school at 5 or 6 years old, all the way up to high school, and even university and college. 17. This is just mind-blowing. May not publicly declare we are to obey God rather than the government. Now think about this now. May not publicly, it says, declare. It means that you can do it privately, but don't you dare say nothing. We are to obey your Almighty Father, you rather than the Babylonian government. Now, brethren, if you were to walk into any 501c3 church in the United States and you were to read this to them, first of all, they would tell you it's just not true. Then if you could even show them, if somebody from the IRS came and said, yes, it's true, they would say, okay, there must be a good reason. If you told the church, hey, we got to get rid of Jesus and support the state of Israel first, they would say, fine, but I thought we were already doing it. You see, Jesus does not live in the church. Your Almighty Father does not live in a church. He does not live in anything that is made by man. The Almighty Father and Jesus Christ live inside of you. We are the church. And how dare any of you ever be fooled as to thinking that you could walk into one of these demonic buildings with their filthy, nasty, corrupt, vile pastors and think that Jesus Christ is there. Jesus Christ is not there. Let me ask you a question. Would any of these churches acknowledge who the true Israelites are? Who killed Jesus Christ? Who did Jesus Christ call the synagogue of Satan? Who is responsible for the creating of the Federal Reserve and deflating the dollar since 1913? Who has destroyed the American family? Will our churches acknowledge the 50 to 75 million men, women, and children who were brutally murdered, tortured, starved, and left destitute in Russia in what we call the Bolshevik Revolution? Will your church acknowledge who has funded and openly supported the devil's children and their agenda to bring wave after wave of people into Western culture countries that hate the people that are already there? I'm just simply asking you, and I did a video called How It Works, if you would like to watch it, that when people talk about immigration, they don't understand the church has played the biggest role in it. They call them clients now, clients, and it starts in the church. How about the churches? Will they acknowledge the hatred toward white people? There is a war against white people, and you know who is at the head of it? Other white folks. And you want to know where most of them are? In the churches. Will the church acknowledge that the majority of jobs have been shipped to China, India, Mexico, and every other country but the host country? Will the church acknowledge that Western culture countries have sent their men and women, moms and dads have sent their boys and their girls to die for the state of Israel for nothing? Will the church ever acknowledge that these monsters have put poisons in our food, water, and every aspect of our lives? Even children's baby formula is contaminated with poison. Would any church ever acknowledge any of this? Remember, from what we just read, they can't say a damn thing about nothing except, oh, we love you, Babylon. We love you. We love you. We are told to love our Father and His beautiful Lamb. And He is the King of Kings, and His name is Jesus. And we are to serve Him and put all of our trust in Him, all of our faith in Him. We do not love this world. I hate to think that I would ever bow to some pathetic piece of dung devil. I bow to nobody but Jesus Christ, and He gets both knees. He gets my face. He gets my bottom. I'll go face down for Jesus, but for nobody else. And if that's what it's going to come to, you might as well kill me now. Get it over with, because you'll never get my knees. I will die on my feet for Jesus. I cannot overstate this enough. We are to hate this world. We are not to love this world. And I'm not talking about the rivers, the lakes, and the mountains. I'm talking about the system. I know the animals are beautiful when they're not being mistreated by these evil, wretched monsters. I'm talking about the system that we are in. This is why we live in spirit. And you understand, you start to understand why Jesus said, we're to live in spirit, to worship our Father in spirit and in truth. Because when you live through the physical, you have to be a part of the system. Then you are forcing yourself to be a part of the system. Let me give you just a couple verses before we close, and then I'm going to give you an update about your sister Annie and her mother Esther. 1 Peter 4:17, judgment will begin at the house of God. Now, I'm not sure if most folks realize how incredibly powerful and telling that this actually is. Judgment begins at the house of the Almighty Father. Second Peter 2:3, and through covetousness shall they with feigned words make merchandise of you. That's Second Peter 2:3. Now, this happens in society, churches, YouTube, movies, corporations. They do it with feigned words, and the word feigned means fake or false. And these false churches are all over the internet, all over Utah, all over YouTube. 490 out of 500 channels that supposedly teach the Almighty Father, they work for the state of Israel. They work for Babylon. And even the ones that you think you can trust have been woven in ever so subtly to make you think that they are anti-this, they're anti-that, when they're actually just snitches for Google. They're there to pull you in so you can be marked. No, not physically, remember, because we've already learned what the mark of the beast is. 2 John 1:10, if there come any unto you and bring not this doctrine, receive him not into your house, neither bid him Godspeed. So we know that the word was written by our Father. Everything was done through our Father. He gave it to Jesus. Now, we're being told if they don't believe what we believe, hey, don't even let them into your house. Neither bid them Godspeed. This is our doctrine. But yet the Bible tells us to love thy neighbor. Yes, you can love thy neighbor. But if your neighbor or if anybody else runs contrary to the Almighty Father, there's going to have to come a time when you're going to have to part ways with them, because we, the light, cannot have any fellowship with the darkness, as we shall soon read. 1 John 4:1, beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world. Matthew 7:15, beware of false prophets which come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ravening wolves. And what do wolves do? They want to prey on the sheep. They want to prey on the flock. Matthew 24:24, look at all the warnings that Jesus Christ gave his children. For there shall arise false Christ and false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonders, insomuch that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect. Acts chapter 20, think about what Paul was saying here. Take heed, therefore, unto yourselves and to all the flock, over the which the Holy Ghost hath made you overseers to feed the church of God, which he hath purchased with his own blood. For I know this, that after my departing, says Paul, shall grievous wolves enter in among you, not sparing the flock. Also of your own selves shall men arise, speaking perverse things to draw away disciples after them. Nothing has changed, folks, in 2,000 years, only it's gotten worse, far worse than it has ever been. Now, 2 Corinthians 6:14, be not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. And most folks in churches, and I'm not saying all, I'm not saying that everybody that walks into a Catholic church or a Protestant church does not have a form of love and belief in Jesus. I'm not saying that, because that would be wrong to say. However, I pose this question to you. Why are they there? Think about it. If God has condemned the church, why would they still be in the church? Just a simple question. 2 Corinthians 6:14, be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship hath righteousness with unrighteousness, and what communion hath light with darkness? Jeremiah 15, one of my favorite verses. I sit not in the assembly of the mockers, talking about when the people would gather together. Jeremiah said, I will not be a part of them. Nor rejoiced I sat alone because of thy hand, for thou hast filled me with indignation. Means he's angry. Means he's pissed. Why is he pissed? Because people are mocking his Father. People are telling the lie, and he's not going to be a part of it. Come what may, he will not be a part of it. You see, we don't have to be a part of them. Let me ask you something. Who's going to get into a contest with your Father? Who's going to push him around? Nobody. He does the pushing. Ephesians 4:14, that we henceforth be no more children tossed to and from and carried about with every wind of doctrine by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness, whereby they lie in wait to deceive. 1 Timothy 4:1, now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits, underline it, and doctrines of devils, underline it. Jude 1:18, how that they told you there should be mockers in the last time, who should walk after their own ungodly lust. Underline that, brethren, ungodly lust, and think about where these people are. That's the modern church, and this is the control that the devil and the Babylon has over the church. Now, if they have that control over the church, think about every aspect of society they have the same control over. Now, what is the only way to counter that? His name is Jesus, brethren. That's how you counter it. Because the state of Israel, Babylon, the bankers, academia, the churches, the liars, Hollywood, the cons, the Masons, Catholic Church, all that, they don't have all power. All together, if you put them all together, they are nothing compared to the King of Kings, Jesus. So, good people, I just want to say something to you in closing. That's the truth about the church. And I would like to give you an update about Annie Horlacher and her mom, a sister on the channel named Monica. She went and got them a few days ago, and they're tucked away. They're warm. They're dry. They have food. They have shelter. And now we're waiting to get them a place to live. And I'm going to wait till after the Memorial Day, because with everything going on with the COVID-19 law, it's made finding a place for them a little bit harder than it normally would be. And I just want to say a word to you, to the folks. I want to thank you for all of you who have prayed, all of you who have donated money, and all of you that sent money to me to give to them. I thank you. And Annie thanks you. And your Almighty Father will take care of you for it. And I'm not going to mention any names because I just think that would be incredibly tacky. Thank you. And if any of you need to call me because you're wondering, hey, where's my money? Are things getting there? You can call me. And I would hope that by now that you folks know you can trust me. I don't claim to be all this or all that, but I do claim to be all me. And I do my best to be a child of my Almighty Father, to be strong, to not take any gruff from people who that want to lie, cheat, and steal, and try to bully folks. I would do the same for you that I did for Annie and her mother. I would stand up for anybody that's being bullied by somebody evil. So if you need to call me, and I received some envelopes today from 5 people, and I'm going to send you an email, and I want to thank you that all of you that went to GoFundMe, we did more than what I thought we would ever do. It was amazing. And all the glory to the Almighty Father in Jesus Christ. In closing, I want to tell you something that was also done to Annie and her mom. For those of you who watched the video about what a devil did to 2 innocent women, I told you a story, and I was very angry. When he dropped this woman off, when he dropped Annie and her mother off, this devil, the last word out of his mouth to them, and he's actually been harassing her since then. He sent her a text the other night at 2:30 in the morning. Remember, I had no way to get in touch with her very periodically for almost 2 weeks because she was in a very remote place. When he dropped her off 3 weeks ago on that remote piece of land, he actually told her, and almost like he was threatening her, Rob better not make a video about this, because this monster knew that other folks were going to know who he really is and what he really is. Well, I did do a video about it, James. And you'll never, ever intimidate this girl ever again, ever. She's been made strong. Her mom has been made strong. And you have been brought to the light. And we know what you really are. Of course, some of us knew what you were a long time ago. And he also, by his own admission, Annie has 3 dogs. They weigh between 5 and 7 pounds. They're tiny. He held 2 of them down to make them stop barking. That's a real man's man, isn't it? I mean, because it takes a real man to harm and abuse women, children, and defenseless animals, doesn't it? James, you're a lucky, lucky man that you can hide behind that monitor. You and some other folks on another channel who have talked bad about people on this channel who aren't talkers of the word, but they're doers. There's going to come a time when you folks are not going to be able to hide behind the monitor. You're very, very fortunate that you can for now. But you are not going to escape the wrath of the Almighty Father. And James, she told me about your comment about the blanket. And close to your skin, you know what I'm talking about, you nasty, nasty man. Then again, calling you a man, that's way too much for you. I digress. There's no more to say about it. Listen, thank you all. May you enjoy your weekend and your holiday. I love you all. I think you're all wonderful. We've been brought together for a reason, and it's bigger than all of us. It's because the Almighty Father, through His beloved Son, Jesus, has brought us together to love Him and to fellowship and to serve Him. And I told Annie last night on the phone that, folks, we can do anything through Jesus. Once we really believe it and mean it, we can do anything. We really can. We have a wonderful, wonderful Father. Thank you all. And if you need to call me, those of you who want to make sure that did we get this or get that, call me. It's all right. I love you all. May all of you be blessed. Be safe. Take care of yourselves. and I will see you all soon. May the Father bless each and every one of you. May He bless your children. May He bless your spouse. May He bless you. May He touch you in the most beautiful of all names. And His name is Jesus. Amen.